فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد، وإن شرح هذا الكتاب التحفة السنية بشرح المقدمة الأجرومية. The author رحمه الله he says محمد محي الدين عبد الحميد he says when the author الإمام الأجروم said الحرف والحرف ما لا يصلح معه دليل الاسم ولا دليل الفعل. So let's read what the matan says first of all. What the matan Ajrumiyah says. What does it say? It says, والحرف, a particle, a harf, is ما لا يصلح. ما لا يصلح. معه دليل الاسم. The evidence of a noun cannot be placed in it. You've already learned علامات الاسم. Have you not? You've learned some of the signs of the noun. Have you not? Yeah. And you've also learned some of the evidences of a what? Some of the signs of a verb. Those two signs which you learned from the noun and the verb, علامات الاسم that you learned, and the علامات الفعل that you learned. So the signs of the noun that you learned and the signs of the verbs which you learned, none of them too can enter into a harf. عدم قبول علامة. It is the fact that it does not accept, that it doesn't accept عدم قبول علامات الأسماء والأفعال. It does not accept the signs of the noun and it doesn't accept the signs of the verb. None of them too can enter it. Does that make sense? يتميز الحرف. Now we're going to go to the matan now. شرح. Look at the شرح now, inshallah ta'ala. By Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid. He says, يتميز الحرف عن أخويه الاسم والفعل بأنه لا يصح. لا يصح الدخول علامة من علامات الأسماء المتقدمة ولا غيرها عليه. That the harf is distinguished from its brothers or its sisters. What are its brothers and sisters? اسم الفعل. لأن بأنه لا يصح دخول علامة من علامات الأسماء المتقدمة. The previous mentioned signs of the noun cannot be in it. ولا غيرها عليه, and other than it cannot enter it. كما لا يصح دخول علامة من علامات الأفعال. Just like it is not correct to place in it the signs of a verb التي سبق بيانها وغيرها عليه. Just like we have previously explained the signs of the verb and the signs of the noun. وَمِثَالُهُ example is مِنْ وَهَلْ وَلَمْ. مِنْ is a what? It's a harf. هَلْ is a what? It's a harf. لَمْ is a what? It's a harf. Are you there? What are those? What are these three? Yeah? They are حروف. But what's the difference? Now, the Sharih Muhammad Abdul Hamid chose those three particles for a particular reason. How many particles did he choose? He chose min. He chose what? Hal. He chose what? Yeah, lam. Why did he specifically choose those three over any other particles there is? Harf jar. Why didn't you take any other harf jar?
I think it's
each
one example of one
mistake. Good, Jamil. Yes. Jamil. The reason why the author chose this is each one, it signifies the three types of verbs, particles there are. The verbs are three types, the nouns are three types, and the huruf are three types. This one, min, are you there? Is what? Mukhtas. It's specific to what? Bil asma. Are you with me? Mukhtasun bil asma. This one is what? Mushtarak. Baina al asma wal mushtarak bayna al asma wal af'al. And this one is what? Mukhtas. مختص بالأفعال. What does that mean? It means min is specific to only nouns. Anything that falls after min is always going to be a noun. Whatever falls after hal can always be a what? هل يستطيع. You can say هل يستطيع. Are you with me? You can also bring after it what? A ism, a noun after it. هل هو. Are you with me, brothers? Huwa is a what? It's an ism, which is mudmar. It's a pronoun. It's a noun in Arabic. So hal, anything that comes after can be a noun and it can be a verb. It's mushtarakun bayna al-asma'i wal-af'al. Does that make sense? Lam hi is mukhtasun bil-af'al. It's specific to verbs. What verb is it specific to though? We'll have a discussion on that inshaAllah ta'ala. But it's mukhtas. Does that make sense? So we've taken that the verbs are three types, we've taken that the nouns are three types, and we've also taken the what? The huruf are three types. Does that make sense? Now, the author now wants to say, Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid, he wants to say to you, هذه الكلمات الثلاثة حروف. These three are huruf. لأنها لا تقبل ال ولا التنوين. None of those three except ال, and none of those three except تنوين. Whose sign is the تنوين and whose sign is the ال? These are the signs of a ism. Sahih. So you never see the word al-min. Al-min. You'll never see that. It will never happen. You will never also see minun. Sah? Are you there, brothers? What's the difference between min and man? One is a noun, one is a harf. Min is a harf. If you place a fatha on top of it, it's a ism. It's a noun, right? Don't confuse the two. Min is a harf, and man is a what? It's a ism. Ism. Are we all together? So the word min, how do we know min is a harf? Because it doesn't accept the signs of the noun. Nor does it accept any signs of the أفعال. It won't accept it. So example, it won't accept seen and sofa. You can't say samin. You can't say sofa min. Does that make sense? It won't accept the alamatul fi'li. So because it doesn't accept alamatul ismi, ولا alamatul fi'li, دل على أنه حرف. It shows that it's a harf. It shows it's what? That it's a harf. It doesn't also accept قد. If I try to put qad in there, it doesn't show. So the summary of what we learned so far before we move on to the next chapter is the following. We learned that the kalima is categorized into what? That the kalima is categorized into what? Three. What were they? Al-ismu. And we categorized it into? Al-fi'lu. And I? Al-harfu. صح. So these are the three types we categorized it into. What did we categorize that حروف into? How many علامات did we mention for the اسم, sorry? Four, right? What were they? Al. Alif al-lam is the first one that we categorized it for. Al-hay. What was the second? So the second one was what? At-tanween. حروف الخفض. أنا الخف. صح؟ These were the al, tanween, حروف الخفض, حروف الخفض itself. The fi'il, how much did we categorize it into? We categorized it into two. What were they? مشترك. صح؟ المختص. مشترك من what? Shared by the what? The ماضي and the مضارع. What did we say was مشترك بين الماضي والمضارع? We said قد was it. So it's مشترك. So just write مشترك بين الماضي والمضارع. صح? And then we had مختص, that which is specific to all of them. We mentioned how many? We mentioned three. The first one was what? Al? Al-Mudari'. What did we mention for the Mudari'? Seen. And sofa. Sah? Seen and? Sofa. Then we went to Al-Madi. What did we mention for the Madi? Ta'nith. As-Sakina, right? And then what was the last one? Yeah? Fi'il Amr. What did we say that the alama that it showed? That we mentioned specifically for it? Dalalatuhu. Ala al-talab, that it shows a request. Wa qabulihi. Ya al-mukhataba. That's what we took so far. And then what did we say about the harf? What did we say about the harf? We said adami qabuli alamat al-asma' wal-af'al. صح. Are we there, brothers? Ancestors. That's what we took so far. Anything else? We're now going to move on to, huh? Ta'ul fa'il and all of that, they fall into. Naam. Does that make sense to all of you guys? This is a mulakhas, a summary of what we took so far and what we studied when it came to the categorization of kalima. Which one? Yeah, there it is. دلالته على الطلب وقبوله يا المخاطبة. يا المؤنث المخاطبة نعم لا بس. Scrum scholars say يا المخاطبة لا بس. جميل. Are we together? Does that make sense? Can we now move on to the biggest chapter in Nahu, Bab al-I'rab? Now we're going to move on to Bab al-I'rabi, which is the next chapter. Is what? Bab al-I'rabi. The author says Bab al-I'rabi, the chapter of I'rab. Al-I'rabu, I'rab is huwa. I'rab is taghyiru, the changing of awakhiril kalimi, the changing of the ending of the word. Why? Likhtilafil awamili, the agents that are entering it are different. Awamil is what? What's the tarif of amil? The ta'rif of amil is ma awjaba kawna akhir al kalimati ala wajh al makhsus. Amil means, and the plural is awamil, in English translation is agent, no problem. But what does it actually translate, explain as Arabic? It means anything that obligates and makes it obligatory, it forces the word, the ending of it, to take a particular way, a particular form. ما أوجب كون آخر الكلمة على وجه المخصوص. It forces it to take a particular face, a particular appearance. من رفع أو نصب أو جزم أو خفض. جر أو خفض أو جزم. من رفع أو نصب أو جر أو جزم. One of those forms it will force it to take. That's what a amil is. For example, a fi'il, what does it make the fa'il become? We're going to take it later, inshallah. It forces it to take rafa. It forces it. It's an agent. It's forcing it. Sah? Are you with me, brothers? What does a mubtada do to the khabar? The same it does. It makes it marfu'. It forces it to be marfu'. Sahih? Are you there? So these are things that force, and inshallah ta'ala, al-dakhilati alayha, that enters onto it. The way that it changes it is two types. Lafzan aw taqdiran. The changing occurs in two ways. Lafzan aw taqdiran. What does the word lafzan actually mean? What does the word lafzan actually mean? Lafzan means أن يكون مسموعا في الملفوظ. What does lafzan mean? Lafzan means أن يكون مسموعا في الملفوظ. That when you utter the change, when you change the word, the sign of it, if you pronounce it, the blind person, okay, he can hear you. He can know there's a changing happening. وَمَرْئِيًّا فِي الْمَكْتُوبِ. And it's something you can see on the writing. There's a changing going on here. That's what's meant by lafzan. If anybody asks you, define what lafzan means, it means أَن يَكُونَ. Lafzan means what? أَن يَكُونَ مَسْمُوعًا فِي الْمَلْفُوضِ وَمَرْئِيًّا فِي الْمَكْتُوبِ. وَمَرِيئًا فِي الْمَكْتُوبِ, sorry. وَمَرِيئًا فِي الْمَكْتُوبِ is the right way of saying it. أَنْ يَكُونَ مَسْمُوعًا فِي الْمَلْفُوضِ وَمَرِيئًا فِي الْمَكْتُوبِ. That it's something you can hear the changing. Are you there? And you can also see what? وَمَرِيئًا فِي الْمَكْتُوبِ. And you can see the changing written in front of you. Are you there, brothers? Let me give you the example. I can rub this off, right? Okay, pay attention here. Ja'a محمود جاء. Let's use the word زيد better. زيد جاء زيد جاء زيد جاء is a what? فعل ماضي. It's a past tense verb. زيد here is what? فاعله فاعله جاء. He's the فاعل of جاء, right? He's the subject of جاء. He's the doer of جاء. صحيح. What's the sign here right now? Look what I. So if you're blind, you can't see what I wrote on the board, and you can't see the board. Okay, and I say جَاءَ زَيْدٌ اسْمَ مَسْمُوعٌ فِي الْمَلْفُوظِ. My, the utterance I'm reading, you can hear me. صح, can't you? جَاءَ زَيْدٌ. If I ask you what's the alama of زَيْدٌ, you say دُن. Okay, جميل. رَأَيْتُ رَأَيْتُ زَيْدًا. رَأَيْتُ is what? فِعْلٌ. فِعْلٌ. And it's also a... It's a فِعْلٌ. And it's also a... فَاعِل. لأن الرأى is فِعْل. The tab by itself is the... فَاعِل. Are you there? So I saw. This is what it is. It's the verb and it's the one who's doing the verb. Okay? زَيْدٌ here is what? It's فاعل رأى, right? It's the فاعل of? Sorry, مفعول, sorry. He's مفعول به, right? Because I just said the فاعل is the two. So زيد is what? مفعول به. What happened to زيد here? It's one name, it's changing. One time you're hearing جاء زيدٌ. When your time you're hearing, رَأَيْتُ زَيْدًا, you're hearing. Again, I give another sentence. مَرَرْتُ 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 بِزَيْدٍ. Here, what do you have? مَرَرْتُ. What's مررتو? فعلا? فعل? And what? فعل, right? Huh? مررتو here is what? The alif, the ba here is what? حرف الجر. زيد here is what? You don't have to worry about that right now. The ba here is حرف الجر. We took that, right? It's a sign unique for the verb. Sorry, for the noun. Zayd here is what? It's a ism majrur. Here, look at Zayd, how many forms that it went through. Ja'a Zaydun, Ra'aytu Zaydan, Marartu bi Zaydin. It's changing. This changing is what's i'rab. Are you there, brothers? This changing that's happening here to this one word, one time it's what? Udun, and one time it's dan, and one time it's din. This changing it, what's i'rab? Okay, there's a khilaf amongst the nuhat. What is i'rab? Is it shay which is ma'anawi, or is it shay which is mahsus? This is another discussion. We're not going to go into it now. Are you there? But the point is, what do we see? It's changing. So if you just take that word zayd right now, okay, if you just take zayd by itself, you see it go through three different. Why is it changing? لاختلاف العوامل الداخلة عليه, right? Why is it changing? Because the agents that are entering it are different, right? Different agents. One time it's a subject, one time it's an object, one time a particle had obliged it to become majrur. Are you with me? Because of the fact that different things, different agents are making it change, this is what i'rab is. Now look at what the grammarians are going to look at. The grammarians don't look at the za, they don't look at the ya, they only look at the dal. That's their job. لِاخْتِلَافِ الْعَوَامِلْ الْدَاخِلَةِ وَتَغِيرُ الْأَوَاخِرِ الْكَلِمِ. They only look at the ending of the wording. They don't look at the middle, they don't look at the front. That's a job of another scholars. They're called what? صَرْفِيِّين. Scholars of صَرْف are the ones who deal with the word, the middle, and why it changes. Ulama in Nahu, they don't. Some people now have an issue here right now, which is Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid, he expands on this issue here right now, which is the taghir here, when you're doing the ta'rif of i'rab, what do you say? Huwa taghiru awakhir al-kalimi. Do you say taghiru awakhir al-kalimi? You say taghiru ahwali awakhir al-kalimi. You have to add that word ahwal in there. Are you there, brothers? Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid alerts that on the sharh of the Ajrumiyya. Why do we say that? Because if you say that the changing occurs from the ending of the word, somebody might think that the dal is going to change to another letter. Does that make sense? And no, that's not the case. So it's not the letter that's going to change. It's the situation on top of the letter that's going to change. So that key term has to be put in there, which is هو تغيير أحوال أواخر الكلمة. It's تغيير أحوال أواخر الكلمة. The sharah you have with Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid, the Tuhfatu Saniyya, it mentions that in the sharah. It's there in the sharah. He says to you, والمقصود من تغيير أواخر الكلمة تغيير أحوال أواخر الكلمة ولا يعقل أن يراد تغيير نفس الأواخر. Don't think to yourself, it's the actual word letter that changes. Does that make sense, brothers? That is called what, sisters? That changing here is the first form of changing. Are you with me, sisters? And brothers, are we all together? Yes or no? Zayd, we just saw it change right in front of our eyes. This is the first form of changing. Lafzan. That's lafzan. Lafzan means what? You can see it and you can hear it. Sah? True or false? That's what the author means by it. هو التغيير الأواخر الكلم لاختلاف العوامل الداخلة عليه لفظا أو تخدير. What do you say لفظا means? أن يكون مسموعا في الملفوظ ومريئا في الملفوظ ومريئا في المسموع لا ومريئا في الملفوظ أن يكون that it is أن يكون مسموع أن يكون مسموعا في الملفوظ right ومريئا في المكتوب نعم. Now let's look at what we mean by that. Okay. So Zayd, can you see it change? Can you hear the changing? Dun, Zaydun, Zaydan, Zaydin. Does it sound the same to you? No, it doesn't. Can you see a change when you look at it? You can, right? That's what's called lafzan. You can see the change and you can hear the change. There's another one. Check it out. It changes, but the changing is something different. What is it? جاء الفتاة رأيت الفتاة مررت بالفتاة الفتاة هي زفاء. Look, same thing. فعل فاعل. فتاة is what? It's the subject. رأيت فعلا فاعل الفتى is what? اسم مفعول به مررت باء is حرف جر الفتى is اسم مجرور. Are you with me, brothers? Yeah? Are we all together? الفتى الفتى الفتى. Can you hear any changes? جاء الفتى رأيت الفتى مررت بالفتى. Can you hear any changes? Yeah? Can you hear any changes? No, you can't. Can you see any changes? They all look the same, right? Does that make sense? They all look there. So this is what it's called taghir, which is muqaddar. It's the second form that the author here mentions to you. And this is the opposite. Alla yakuna masmu'an fil malfudhi. That you can't hear it. There's no hearing. You can't hear anything. Wala mari'a fil masmu'i. Wala fil maktubi. And in the writing, there's nothing that's going to be changed. You can't see it on the writing as well. Yes or no, brothers and sisters? Are we together? Question. Are you strides? How many letters are the alphabet in the Arabic language? How much is the alphabet in the Arabic language? No one say anything. 27, 29, 28, 27, 30, 35. Abbas, help him. 28. Hey, Saad, how many is it? Yeah, 29. Imran, how much? 29, hey? Yeah? 28. Hey? Wallahi, if we have a problem with how much the alphabet, we need to take a step back, right? Ya ikhwa, the alphabet is 28, khalas, there's no other qawl. Hamza and Alif are different. We're talking about grammar. The other funun, they can differ if they want to. The alphabet of the Arabic language is 28. Are you there, brothers? Are we all together?